Hey everybody, Bonez here, Bonez Garage, bringing you up to date what's going on at the garage. So, 1969 Charger SE, car's coming out great. I brought you up to date not too long ago, showed you all under here. Another thing that I wanted to show you on this car is the ignition system. We replaced everything. We ended up putting a new distributor in here. We also had taken out the points, put in the electronic setup for it. So this way, it's a much stronger spark, as you know, and it's a much more reliable system than the points. We put in the new coil, which is a 45,000 volt coil. And if you guys follow me, you'll know that the originals are only 25,000 volts. So you're almost doubling your spark output. We put new spark plug wires, got some nice heavy duty spark plug wires to handle all that charge. We put a nice fuel filter in here, and it's a really good fuel filter. Keeps a lot of the dirt out of the carburetor, and we can keep track of if there's any dirt in the fuel lines and if we have to re-clean the fuel lines, because again, cost prohibitive, we didn't replace the fuel lines. Just a lot more work, a lot more money, and a lot more time. So the customer just wants to get it running for the rest of the season, and later on we'll probably do all that kind of work. We cleaned up all the wiring under the hood. We replaced all of the heater hoses under here, all of the fuel lines, vacuum lines. We replaced 90% of them. Cleaned up a bunch of crap underneath here. And the next thing I want to show you is a lot of the old and used parts that came off of this car. And here you can see that's the old upper radiator hose, that's the lower radiator hose. Here are the old spark plug wires, the old distributor that we took out. And the main reason we replaced this is because the bushings down here were worn out. And this distributor, the shaft, was rocking in and out on the top side of it. Also, the vacuum advance was bad. And for this year, this motor, these vacuum advances are around $100. A new distributor is $120. Go figure. Buy a whole new distributor, comes with a brand new vacuum advance, everything's beautiful and good. These are the original hoses to the car, as far as we know. So we're keeping those. He can keep them if he wants, sell them with the car if he ever sells the car. We put the new spark plugs in it, got rid of this old Mallory coil. They're good in their time, they suck now. Better off with the ignition system we have in there now. These are the old brake shoes. There's the old wheel cylinder, and you can see it was leaking. All down here is all wet. Here's another wheel cylinder. These are the old rear brake shoes and all the old hardware that goes for the brakes. And you can see how bad everything was leaking. See how wet that spring is? It shouldn't be wet. It should be nice and dry like the springs up here. So you could see that was leaking. Also, the lower adjuster. That is totally wet and filled with all kinds of dirt. So just easier to replace them than it is to try and clean them all up and put another one in. Or put it back in. Another thing we replaced is the old thermostat housing. And you can obviously see why we replaced it. We ran some flush through the motor and tried to clean out the motor as much as possible. A little bit worried about the dirt that's inside the motor might get around into the new radiator. But it's kind of a chance you have to take. We couldn't run that old radiator because it just won't hold water. This is the old water pump right here, and that's the impeller, and that's what actually circulates your water. So this actually turns like that, and that circulates your water around. And you can see here, it was starting to leak. So replace it. Just real easy to do, a lot easier than messing with an old thing. This is your air cleaner, and anybody knows air cleaners, they're not supposed to be brown or gray. They're supposed to be nice and white. This is the old master cylinder, and you can see how bad the seals were leaking. This is supposed to all be dry. And you can see how wet that is. So again, easier, just replace it. It's gonna save him a lot of headaches. Here's part of the old exhaust system, and this is the left side. And I guess you can see why we replaced it. It's just beat to crap. Here's another one of the exhaust pipes. And yeah, it's not supposed to have that dent in it, nor is it supposed to have that bend in it, nor is it supposed to have that rip right there. So we're putting a brand new exhaust system in here, and can't wait to get that in and get it running. So there you go. There are some of the old parts that came out of this car. There is more under there, but I figured I'd show you a few of them and why we replace what we replace and why we're doing what we're doing. One of the other things that I really would have liked to replace is right here. These are the lower control arm struts, and they go from here all the way back this way to the lower control arm, and it keeps the lower control arm in line. It keeps it from going back and forth. Problem is, the rubbers are starting to go bad. But again, if we're going to do this, we have to go into everything else for it. So he said to leave it for now. Come winter time, he'll bring it back and we'll replace all of the suspension rubbers, front and rear. So for now, we're going to let it go the way it is. So there you go. Little update on the 69 Charger. Can't wait to get this thing running. I love these cars. They are just such a classic look, that Coke bottle look to them. What a beautiful car. Alrighty, guys. I'll talk to you in a little bit. Have fun. Okay, bye.